Hi Year 7s, today we're going to learn about drawing with pencil. This is the equipment you'll need. You'll need paper from your visual arts process diary. You'll need a 4B pencil or whichever pencil you were given with your art kit. And you will also need to have a toning block. This tone goes from dark all the way to light. So tone is about the lightness and darkness of an object and the shadow. You also need an eraser like shown. With your pencil, 4B is great, 6B is fine. If you can sharpen the pencil so that it has a nice sharp point, ready to start shading. And what we're going to do first is make some shading worms. What are shading worms? You need to get your tonal block nearby, and by pressing harder with your pencil, you're going to create darker lines, so darker shading. If I put the shading block next to these darker shadings that I'm doing at the moment, they're just about a centimeter wide that I'm drawing through the paper. You can go back and forward on a place if you don't think you've got it quite dark enough. As you get lighter against the tonal block, your pencil has less pressure on the page. So you don't press as hard with the pencil. You press lighter and lighter as you get towards the end, and to basically fade out to nothing at the end. So the shading worm matches the tones. I'm just touching up a little bit of tone here, because it's not quite dark enough and doesn't match much better. So the dark tones, I need to press harder with my pencil and my hand, and the light tones, I need to press lighter and release the pressure on my pencil to make a nice, smooth shading worm. Okay, cover that one up, start another one. You actually need to keep doing this until you get it completely right. Ask the person next to you to have a look and tell you whether you've got it spot on in terms of tone. Now we're going to have a look at something called cross-hatching. This is making tone by crossing over lines going in different direction. If you start with lines in one direction on a diagonal, like your shading worm all the way along, don't change the tone, and then change direction so that the lines are crossing over in the opposite direction, and you're crossing those lines as you can see here. You don't need to change the pressure on your pencil. We're just building up an amount of line so that we can get darker tone. Now you're only going to build up the line crossing over as far as you need to. So when you reach the tone where you have enough pencil on the page to match the lighter tones, stop crossing. And you can see the way that I'm doing it now. I'm going to stop in a moment because I don't need to go any further. That's it. Now I'm going to cross in a different direction to try and build up the pencil and make some really, really dark areas. But I don't need to go the whole way down the tonal block because the pencil is building up in layers and it is going to create a darker and darker tone. Just fixing up that very last bit with some extra cross-hatching so that I get a really dark tone. Your last exercise is to make a shading block, just like the one that we've given you. So what you're going to do is rule out around a straight ruler, make some measurements about 2 centimeters apart. You might need to go across the long edge of your page so that you have the full length to do all the different spaces. So divide it up like this, very light lines so that you don't have great big hard lines in between. Please make sure you use your pencil lightly. Now hold your shading block next to the one that you've created, and you're going to use smooth strokes to fill in the actual rectangles. Now, I'm doing strokes that are these little loops. But when I put them all together and work really quickly, it creates a nice smooth shading effect. I'm just showing you what the loops look like and when they're blended all together, how they work. So of course I need lots of pressure on my pencil to get through this first one. And I need to be able to shade it in, be neat with the edges. If you go over the edges though, you can use your eraser and just rub it straight off the edges again. So what you're doing mostly is little loops at the corners. You will need to straighten it up with your pencil. And then what we do in art is we use what's called a chamois, but we don't have chamois, they're made of leather. But we do have paper towel, which has a similar effect. If you've got tissues in your bag, tissues work really well, unless they've got moisturizer in them. Don't use moisturized tissues. Tear off a little piece of paper towel, you only need a little bit. Wrap it around your finger, so it looks like that. And blend the square that you've just done. Or rectangle, I should say. So what you're doing is you're kind of polishing the graphite into the texture of the paper. Now I need to make that a little bit darker, so I'm adding some more graphite so I get it to the level of that really black grey square that starts the beginning of our toning block. Polishing it up. And then I'm going to start the second one. So I'm going in for the next colour. So starting, building up the grey so that you don't start with the darkest colour you possibly can. You start lighter and you build it up in layers until you get it to that same darkness. And check it all the time because there should be a difference between this box and the next one and the next one and so on. Working in those little loops and just straightening things up at the corners. And working over it until we achieve that total tonal change. So your job will be to create your own tonal block. After this, there's an exercise on applying what you've learned to actually toning a shape. So we have a worksheet to give you that has a sphere shape on it and also a circle in which you're going to draw. And that's at the end of the video. So you're going to draw with darkest tone first to shade a tonal block. And then after you finish this exercise, you may ask for the worksheet to complete on the shaded sphere. Okay, the exercise that you're going to finish with is this shading exercise where we are going to match our tonal block with a shaded sphere. There's a circle pre-drawn and you're going to basically copy this using the shading techniques that you've learned into the sphere at the bottom. Okay, see you then.